Firstly, your views on the market, which are at least closing the day in the green for a change.
Yeah, I think over the last, we've seen the index moving up over the last 3 or 4 days. It seems in correlation with the strengthening of a shilling. So it's pretty good, although it was a marginal gain, and the market has been rather flat, except for some counters such as KCB and KPLC, which KPLC are closing their books tomorrow.
Okay, let's talk about the stronger shilling, just over 83 shillings, 25 thereabouts. I think buoyed also by the monetary policy decision to raise interest rates by 25 basis point. What else is working in favor of the currency?
I'd actually say that would be the major driving factor. Actually, I think when the MPC was moving up its CBR rate, it was actually looking to strengthen the shilling. And in fact, about 2 days later, after raising the CBR rate, they came to the market to do a repo, which I mean, they haven't done a repo for quite some time, quite a while. So they've been tightening liquidity. It looks as if maybe they've been pushing. They're pushing investors to sell off dollars, but it's actually working positively towards strengthening the shilling. We're hoping as the shilling strengthens and gets to levels that CBK seems to find acceptable of about 80, 81 levels, they may loosen their stance somewhat, the monetary stance somewhat.
And Kenneth, how's that playing out in terms of investments in the fixed income side, the secondary and the primary markets? Because we know that the recent declines in the equities has just led to investors withdrawing a little bit or just holding on to their positions.
What's happening with the shilling and with the interest rates is actually affecting the fixed income market quite negatively, with most investors quite jittery. Most are not making any moves. And what happened, in fact, to the primary we had about a week ago, was the rates, especially for the five-year paper, went up by over 100 basis points to levels of about 8.5. So that has actually put a lot of papers underwater, because the 10-year paper was trading at levels of 8%, the 15-year papers at levels of 8.5 to 9%. So the market is quite jittery. A lot of investors are hurting, their books are underwater. So, but we're hoping once the monetary policy eases up, as the shilling strengthens, we might see more activity on the fixed income market.
I mean, let's continue to talk on this tack, because obviously there are other factors that investors need to consider when they're looking at Kenyan bonds, the risk sentiment around possible elections going forward. There's been a lot of concerns about the state of the Grand Coalition. How is that reflected just by way of bond deals? Even if people are withdrawing from the fixed income side, it's a good barometer as to what investors think of risk in Kenya.
I think when it comes to elections and political noise, if I may call it that, it's actually never quite affected the fixed income market, especially since most of the investors are local. And although the foreign investors have increased in our market, but The political noise has never really affected our fixed income market. What happens actually is what we see a lot of investors are moving from the from equities into bonds to the safety of fixed income instruments. And I don't think moving into 2012 it will be any different. And the political climate is improved actually. It's pretty good. We don't expect a repeat of what happened in 2007. So going forward, I don't think the political climate will really affect the fixed income market. What the main driving factor for our market is interest rates and also a lot of speculation.
All right, let's talk about some of the results coming through. Obviously, a slew of results that have come through. The banks did particularly well, with average growth of 40%. And it seems that the insurers have followed suit, with average earnings up 12 to 15%. What's that likely to mean for further investments in this segment of financial services, the insurers in particular?
From the beginning of the year, most of the market was pushing on financials, because we all expected good results in comparison to 2009 to 2010. The results were pretty good. The financial sector has cooled down somewhat, but now going forward, I think most people are looking forward to the book closures and to the first quarter reporting.
Lemura Tea Company released full year 2010 results. Profits before tax up 169%. Directors there recommending a final dividend of about 7 shillings 50. Your views?
This is one of the few gainers, people who've gained from a much weaker shilling, and also better tea prices. We thought the drought that we had would affect them quite a bit, but actually didn't seem to. But I think they're pretty happy. The shilling, the weakening of the shilling really helped push up their profits.
I mean, obviously, Kenya is an agricultural-based economy. That's the mainstay of the economy. Going forward, already the looming threats of drought, higher inflation, and a bit of foreign exchange volatility. How is that going to impact on agro stocks?
I think the agricultural sector, in fact, for the budget for 2011-2012, it seems the government wants to cut back on agricultural spending, which I actually don't agree with, it being one of our main GDP earners. But going forward, the drought, we are expecting short rains. The meteorological department has actually told us to expect them. So going forward, agro stocks will be a buy, especially what happens with agricultural stocks. They usually buy during the second half of the year when the weather is a lot better.